Is there anything else that can go wrong today?
Make it stop.
I'm trying. In the wonderful world of Spectrum Internet, today we hopefully will have a podcast for you. Welcome to Talk Around Town, episode 18.
Oh, man. It's getting 18. Up there.
Let's say it like we do every week. Can you believe it's 18? I can't
believe it.
With us today is the lovely Heather.
Hello.
From Heather's. Hello. Heather from Heather's.
Heather from Heather's.
It's great to have you here.
Kind of, but you know.
Yeah, you have your own place named after you.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It is. Hopefully, guys, if you see any freeze-ups, just bear with us. We're having, like I said, a few internet issues as we record this, but we'll muddle through it. And Jeff from Route 88 is with me. Mr. Jeff.
What's going on? Great, great, great. Right? How are you, Mr. Scott Hall?
I'm doing well,
Miss Heather,
man.
How are you?
Yeah, hello.
It's been a busy week. Busy.
It has. It is one of those weeks, isn't it?
Things are coming back.
I keep thinking it's Friday. I don't understand. Yeah, all day I thought it was Friday.
I wish it was Friday already. No.
It is actually. When we put this out, it's actually Friday. So we can say it's Friday.
We can pretend it's Friday right now.
Because these launch at Friday at 10 a.m. So
perfect.
Yeah. And all of our three listeners and viewers know that. So they know to be there on Fridays. That's in fact, we may have had four this week, Jeff. Look at that shameless plug. Route 88.
Kept like that? Frozen. Hold on. Let me drink very slowly.
Slowly show that to everybody.
I failed. I don't have a Heather's cup.
I don't even have a cup in here. That's how busy I've been. I'm a
leader.
Let's talk something fun. Spring has sprung. And somebody ringing?
Oh, sorry.
Is that you?
It is. It's my phone.
Okay. I know how many. I did an interview with you in person, Heather, and I know how many texts you get. So turn that crap off. I muted it. Silence that. Silence.
She's a busy lady.
Oh, she's a rock star. Oh, she is a rock star. Heather is a rock star in Springboro, Ohio.
No.
And parts around town. She is. So it's patio season. Patio season's coming. And one of my favorite patios, and I'm sure Jeff will agree, is to be on the patio at Heather's. It's just magic.
Thank you.
It is magical.
We literally cannot wait.
Well, I know you can't wait because, first of all, let's just put it out there. That's your moneymaker. Oh, I mean, it is.
People think we're not here in the winter, but we really are here.
Yeah. And sometimes it's just we.
It's just Skylar and Alex and myself, and we're like, so should we drink?
Yeah. Wine tasting today? What are we doing? Yeah, Heather's actually has a coffee shop, you know, and a nice place to sit and have brunch, lunch, whatever.
Yeah.
It's really cool. It's a neat place to be. It's ringing again, Heather.
I've been muted. I don't know how to make it stop. I'm very tech challenged.
Can you bring Alex in, please? I know. Where's Alex? Alex behind the camera knows how to do this.
Well, there we go. I got it. Now we're
Jeff,
good.
This is going to be out of control. I can
That's
see
all right.
I haven't even
we're going to leave all this in too. All the footage is staying there. We're not cutting anything.
No, this is a straight run today.
Yeah.
No fixing it in post, as they say. No. We're just going to do it. So patio season's coming up. And let's first of all, let me throw out here. I know a little bit about your history because I got a chance to do a really great interview with you. Mm-hmm. And man, you are popular. I will say that.
And now I'm going through my computer. I don't know how to make this stop. I swear.
So Heather, when you opened Heather's, how many years ago was it?
We opened in November of 2009.
Okay, you had this idea to have a little patio out back.
I did.
This little bitty patio.
It was so cute. Yeah. When we look back at old pictures, we're like, what were we thinking? But we were thinking it would just be these, you know, we had all these like little areas like with cushioned chairs and all this stuff where people would sit. And it's, you know, we were going to do wine tastings and just let people sit outside and have conversation. And then kind of my love for music took over. And we had a customer who had offered, he's like, you need some music out here. So I kind of blame him. So because they kind of became like our house band. That was Michael Brooks. And then it was like each year we just added another section of the patio. God love my dad, he would, you know, move the fences again, and, you know, we'd add more tables and chairs, and every year it would just kind of be so, yeah. But yeah, we were just going to hang out and sip coffee.
So now upwards of like 6,000 square feet out there, right?
It is it's just a little over 6,000 square feet on the patio now.
Mm-hmm. And what's your capacity pre-COVID?
I can get 300 out there. And you know, with COVID, we didn't really, I mean, we went down to like 225, 250 ish. It really depended on, it was dependent upon the size of the parties and things of that nature. Cause it is something, I wish I had never done, but I almost have to, you know, we take reservations. So we reset that patio on the daily. We didn't lose a ton of seats. We just kind of, you know, we took some out, but you know,
cause it makes it a lot, it made it a lot easier, I'm sure, to book big parties. So then that way you didn't actually diminish your crowd, because you're putting the parties far enough apart. You could have parties of only 10,
only 10.
And so, that way yeah. you didn't exceed the limit, but you can still get people in there.
Yeah. And you know, I go to, you know, when you go to places and you see like a group of people come in and they just start taking chairs from tables, and that's always just driven me insane, because and essentially you're losing seats. So, you know, I came up with this brainchild probably, I don't know, 6 years ago to take reservations. And so that's why we do that. So we don't lose the tables, the table space and the seats and things of that nature. So, but you know, it's kind of funny, my phone, as soon as there's like a nice day, my phone starts dinging and people are making reservations. I already have like 20 reservations for Cinco de Mayo, the first night for music trivia. I have
hot diggity. I like that.
That's good, right?
You know, we got 200, yes. We got 200 to go, but you know, I've got people that have already made reservations for August. I'm like, man, I need to get through May first.
Well, yeah. It talks to your popularity. It yeah. does. We said at the beginning of the show, so many people have called your business home in Springboro. I mean, they come there on the weekly basis, sometimes 3 and 4 times a week. I see them there on music trivia night. Then we see them on Friday and Saturday to see bands. It's a family. It is.
It is. It is. It definitely is. And, you know, the groups, I mean, you know, the friend groups that travel, they keep coming back. So we love it and we appreciate it so much.
Well, how's that feel to be, I mean, I said at the beginning of the show, you have rock star status in Springboro. How's it feel to be the person, first of all, that everybody wants to know, because you've got the coolest patio going.
And I'm just the biggest nerd in the whole world too. So I'm really kind of a recluse, but no, I appreciate it. If anything else, it's an appreciation for everyone that has, you know, been with us, you know, the entire time we've been open, you know, whether it be, you know, and I laugh sometimes that people that come in during the daytime have no idea there's a patio, you know, 50 feet from them. And then the people who come in at night, they're like, oh, wait a minute, you have a coffee shop? You know, it's just a fun dynamic, you know, but I don't know. I love it. I do. I do. I love it. I love the people, and we wouldn't be here without them. 100%.
Well, and it does. It be like I've said to you numerous times. We've talked about it. Our Wednesday nights, man, when we do Name That Tune, that developed into this family. That the final night this year was, I mean, there's people that were sad. I mean, we were all sad that it was over. Yes. And that was tough. It was, you know, it's just, and your business is such a cool place. And the kitchen is about the size of a postage stamp.
Oh, yeah.
And yet, yet you get 300 people there on Wednesday nights for trivia. Yeah. And in an hour, they're all served food and they're happy. And it it says a lot for what you guys do, because there's little places that can't pull this off with 50 people, you know?
And I see, it's crazy because if people did see our kitchen, I mean, it is tiny. And, you know, I appreciate you so much for always saying, okay, everybody, you know, you just got here at 6:30, 6:45, you know, be patient, because it is a small kitchen. And we don't have, you know, we've got one oven. We have a panini. So I did add a piece of equipment this year, you know, and it's like, you know, I always say it's like stuffing 2 pounds of sausage in a 1 pound pack, trying to figure out how to make it fit. But you know, we added a new piece of equipment this year, so we've got some new things.
Oh, new menu items.
Yes. I'm cutting stuff, you know. It's always hard to take things off the menu because, you know, there's always those customers that are like, well, I just want this, or I know Heather, can you make that for me? Or, you know, this or that. But yeah, as crazy as it is, and you know, everybody else does it, we just never have, but we're adding burgers and fries this year. So and it seems so silly that that's a big deal, but people have begged me for years, and I've always been like, okay, we don't have fryers, you know, we don't have this stuff. So that's something that's going to be huge this year that we add. And I think it will just be insane. And we've been working on a lot of different recipes over the winter on some different appetizers and stuff like that. Probably why I've gained so much daggone weight, but we just sample and make stuff all day long. So.
Yes.
Well, maybe Jeff, what you should do is just close, you know, just build that patio out, put in a permanent fixture roof, you know, what would you think about that?
Well, you know, if it was up to me, that would have been done years ago. That is not something that is up to Heather.
Oh, that's up to the city, I'm sure.
The city, I am not allowed to have a permanent structure on my patio.
Oh, really?
Yeah, crazy, isn't it? Or Dora. Oh. That's okay. We won't go there.
It's called the Historical Society, I think. Yes. All that too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that gets real fun.
And it's something to do with like me being on a corner lot and I already have two structures on my property. I don't know. I don't know. We'll skip that.
But that's one of the great things about your patio though, is as opposed, you know, being in a band and playing on different patios, that's the difficult part of playing on other patios is because they're not covered. And that's always the nice thing. You know, you can have inclement weather and it can be raining or whatever, but you can still have a patio full of people and out there and enjoying music and doing everything and playing and having a good time. Whereas most patios, you have to make that decision when you're setting up. Okay, are we playing inside? Are we playing out? And then if the storm doesn't roll in, guess where everybody's sitting? You're sitting inside playing music to nobody because they're all sitting on the patio.
Yeah, we have, like last year, not 2 years ago, we have the big tent that covers like the majority, and then we added another tent on the side. And that's kind of, we kind of coined that as the party zone. That's where we put the big parties over. It's right off the side of the barn. And it is, it makes it great. Because we didn't cancel it all last year with anything. Because we can get about 125 to 150 under the main tent, even with music. So, which is bigger, larger than what most, you know, patios are. So it makes it nice. You'll be happy. We are adding a stage this year.
Really?
Yeah. Dad's building a stage. Yes.
Elevated stage.
Yes.
Awesome.
Crazy.
That's awesome. I'm glad to hear that. Sometimes it is tough to see, you know, with the big room like that and the wide spaces. That'll be good.
It is.
Yeah,
it is.
That's cool. And you know, we didn't have any rain last year on Wednesdays.
No.
Every Wednesday for the whole season. And we went from May to November. Never had a rain day on a Wednesday last year. But boy, did we have one with Spongeworthy one night down there. The great what I want to call it, the Springboro River flowed through Heather's.
It was a squeegee night, you know, where Jerry was out there squeegeeing like a maniac.
Oh my gosh. And the guys were pulling their pedals off the floor. Jeff, the water was running over Scott's pedals and Spongeworthy and all that. And they're trying to put all that stuff up on blocks. It was crazy. And it monsooned that night. Hours.
They never stopped.
Never quit playing. No. The crowd never quit. The crowd danced. There were people outside under the area that's not covered dancing in the rain.
Dancing in the rain.
A little silly because there was lightning and everything else. But, you know, they're just having fun, man. They're having a good time.
It was great.
Is your opening night going to be Cinco de Mayo? Is that your first night on the patio, or are you guys?
No.
Is that your official kickoff?
Typically, our opening night is always the first Friday in May, but okay. We would have lost an entire week. So we are actually official opening night is April 30th. And we have Velvet Crush full band playing that night.
Okay.
Yahoo.
And then the tents will be here on the 12th. It takes us about a week to get those up, tweaked, lights put up, all that fun stuff. So the official opening is April 30th.
All right.
Outstanding.
Yeah. Good since deal. In years past, COVID kind of made you rethink how you do things, I guess you could say.
Mm-hmm.
And, in years past, we've always done a lot of catering. And, and when all of a sudden you can't do catering. So we did music on Saturday nights last year. So that's something that this year I've got only one Saturday, and it was from a wedding that was pre-booked from last year. We're doing music every Saturday night too. So, and we're going to add Tuesday nights. So
we'll really?
Yes.
So we're thinking, aren't you doing, cause you're doing Thursdays too. I think we've got some Thursdays down there.
So we'll have acoustic on Tuesdays. Scott will have Name That Tune on Wednesdays. Thursdays will be acoustic. And then Fridays rocking it out. Saturdays rocking it out. So we're just kind of switching things up a little bit, changing gears to how we do things. So it'll be fun. I'm excited.
Yes. I'm always happy to be a household name on Wednesday.
Yes.
Yeah, I got to make it down to one of those friends of ours that always come all the time. They actually, they're the party that always is with Brandon and, winning every week, I guess, from what I see. And so that night that we came down, they're like, well, do you want to play on our team or do you want to be on your own? We're like, no, we'll just drag you down a little bit. So you guys go ahead.
So, they know everything. So.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes. And
you never know who's going to get up and sing, too, throughout the night with us. I mean, we do that occasionally, too. It's kind of fun.
Or the dance-offs.
Oh, yeah, the dance-offs. Oh. And then we had our little dance squad there, some kids that are there. They were having fun. That was a blast. But, Heather, that you just said, music is the key to that patio, and you're doing it Tuesday through Saturday. So you get inundated by musicians, and people call me a lot and they say, oh, Scott, can you get us in Heather's or can you get us in somewhere? Cause I can't get any response. Well, people need to realize that Heather not only is a bar owner and she's booking music, but she's also ordering food, drinks, beverages, taking deliveries.
Yes.
Serving customers that are there. Yeah. So there is a little more to the job than just being at your beck and call as a musician when, if you don't hear back in a day or two, maybe they're busy. They're not ignoring you. They get offended by that.
And I don't mean it bad at all, but as you've heard my phone and my computer dinging like crazy, it's part, and I love it because, there's so much talent out there that you have the ones, your staples that you're always going to have, but there's so much talent out there, it's unbelievable. And I like to save some dates back for those people that you didn't know of, or they're a little different, and I like so many different genres of music because I just think it appeals to different people and you get a different clientele. I mean, if you have the same stuff all the time, you're going to have this, the same people coming all the time. And I get, every year, typically in January, I put out that post and I do it every year. So I'm sure that some of the other bars are like, thanks, Heather, about time you did that so we could see some talent too. But I love to hear who everybody wants to see and who they want to hear, because every year somebody brings somebody up that I've never heard of before. And, just like with Marcy, too, I spend hours and hours listening to the musicians. When somebody sends me something, I go find them. And I don't want to hear something recorded because, I could sound good recorded. So I go find them live, or that's what I do in the winter. I go around the different places and just listen. But I love our area. It's just... the musicians are amazing. you know, there's a, you know, I'm going to call them kids because they are kids, but there's this group that just kind of just came on the thing, and I went and listened to them, and I'm like, I can't believe these kids are 16, 17, and 19. It's absolutely unbelievable. And, you know, so I booked them, and, you know, they were ecstatic. They're like, oh my, you know, the dad was like, we've come there and we've listened to some of the bands that play there, and this is amazing. And, but these kids, holy cow. They're the Wright brothers. I don't know if
you're
from a long line of musicians, but they're off the hook. And it's not somebody that, you know, I would have even heard about, you know? So
just I'm looking forward to seeing them, by the way. I've only seen videos and they're fantastic. So that'll be fun.
Well, and that's awesome that you're giving these guys that break too. And I like what you said earlier is that you like to leave some dates open for other bands, because I was actually talking to some other venue owners, and you know, they gave us a few dates and whatever, and they're like, well, we're not booking all the way to the end of the year this year, because every year we get to, you know, June, July, you get to October, and you've got these bands that are fantastic, but you're like, sorry, I'm already booked.
Yeah.
So they're like, no, we're leaving some open dates, because you know, you can always fill stuff probably relatively easy.
Yeah.
And so you might as well leave it open for some of these new people to get out there. And like you said, bring in some new customers.
Well, and that's kind of been the fun thing with Tuesdays, because, you know, Tuesdays, obviously, I don't want to like shake people's windows downtown on Tuesday nights, you know, so it's been kind of fun. So like the, you know, more solo or the duos or the, you know, the trios, but it's a nice way for maybe someone new to try it out and not have 250, 300 people staring at them, or to be able to fill 4 hours of music or 4.5 hours of music. Hi. When you can just fill, you know, the 3 hours, or, you know, like I've got one guy who he's like, I can't fill 3 hours. And I'm like, well, do you have two buddies? And he's like, yeah, they're, you know, they're wanting to be heard too. And I'm like, bring them. You know, I just think that's the fun thing in it. So,
yeah. So much fun. And yeah, and it is that time of year that everybody's trying to get booked. And honestly, for the musicians that watch our podcast, you know, you can't wait till the last minute to get booked in somewhere. And there's a lot of good bands out there that all of a sudden they say, oh, it's a patio season. It's May. Let's start booking. That's too late. You know, you've got to get it in before that.
Well, and you know, like there were some bands like I try to shift gears a little bit once we hit like the high school football season, if you will. And I know it's silly, but you know, Springboro's a huge football town. So I tried to, and how everyone's so interconnected in town, I try to get bands that are more like Cincinnati oriented, or, you know, further Dayton oriented. So they're going to bring different people. So while everyone clears out at, you know, 7:30 or 8 o'clock to go watch the football game, I still have people here. So, and you know, with that, we found some really amazing bands out of Cincinnati too, you know, which are just, so I'm kind of stoked. There were some bands actually that I found out at Belle and the Bear when I went to her open mic night, the jam sessions. I mean, holy wow. So I'm excited to bring some of them to town, but you know, I did miss out on a couple because, you know, they had sent me something early and I didn't get to them. And, you know, so they were already booked, but you know, I saved some dates in case they get some cancellations. So
there's always a standby list just in case.
Yes, there is. Or, you know, I'll send them to Marcy. Marcy sends me stuff all the time because she doesn't like to have more than three, like a trio. And you know me, I like big bands. So especially on the weekends. So she sends me stuff too, which is nice.
That's your new slogan. We like big bands and we cannot lie. There we go. So let me change gears here just a second. You, about your business, you've got a little building out back that I think is just magical as well. Mm-hmm. And do you call that the barn or the man cave? Which one is it?
It depends on my mood. I'm out here right now.
Yeah, I thought that's where you were.
Yeah, I'm out here right now.
Here, let me widen that up a little bit. We'll take a look. There we go.
There it is.
These doors behind me open up to the street. So they're always open when we're open. It's kind of like the calling. Hey, the doors are open. They must be open. Let's go. But, you know, some people call it the barn. Some people call it the man cave. It too has had, you know, major differences over the years. You know, it's funny, we were laughing a couple weeks ago that we used to just have like lawn chairs that we'd stick in here. You know, we'd just sit in here and talk and hang out. And, you know, now it's, you know, my dad has built, you know, all the tables that are in here. He built the bar. He's built all the shelving. He even built the beer cooler. So, but it is a great place. It's kind of like my safe spot, if you will. Like we're here every morning, you know. We're not even open until 8 o'clock, and we're typically here by 6:45 in the morning. Still have my group of guys that come in for coffee. We sit around and bullshit and talk and talk about the world. And, you know, then at night it kind of transitions into the, you know, the cool place, I guess you could be. I guess
where the cool kids hang.
Where the cool kids hang. Yes. I mean, it's funny because there's certain people, you know, like next door, from Eve's Inc. I mean, there's one table they like in here, and, you know, they always call in the morning and they're like, hey, reserve, you know, we'll be over by like 8 o'clock. And so, I mean, they like the table right here that I'm sitting at, which is right by the door. And so people just like certain tables and they like certain things. And it's just I don't know, it's a cozy feeling in here. We are adding Kino out here though. So, I'm getting crazy.
The madness will never end.
It will never end. No.
So, Heather, real quick, because we're running out of time, but real quick, mention your dad. I know how influential he's been to your business and his help and his touches on everything there. So mention that a little bit, will you?
I always say he makes me look good. He makes me look really good. Yeah, I wouldn't be near as cool as I am, I guess you could say, if it wasn't for my dad. I mean, honestly, I know a lot of people say that, but, you know, he is such a perfectionist, and he is just, he just gives and gives and gives. And, you know, he's building new, like, he spent the winter building these tables, and, you know, he builds this stuff out of, like, upcycling is what he calls it. So, you know, he's been building tables at his house, so we're going to have, you know, we can put it in and we can equal it out to 15 people, or we can have four tops. I mean, he's just, his mind never stops. And I always say he was a tool and die guy with an engineering mind. And, but even the landscaping, I mean, he does that now. I mean, he's always done that. And now he has my son helping him on Fridays. So it's just, he's amazing. Like I said, I wouldn't be near as cool without him.
And Jeff, you can attest to this as well. The landscaping and the just the ambiance of the patio at Heather's is like none other. I mean, it's you know, if Hugh Hefner were there, it'd be his grotto, because it's just that kind of place. It's that cool.
And it is a fantastic place. And, you know, we don't make it down there as often as I would like, because, you know, we're a good 40 minutes or more from there.
Yes.
And so, but I love the little barn area where you're sitting right now. I think it's just so cool. You just walk in and just everything that you have there, just the layout and just the look in itself. I mean, I love it down there. I love coming down there to watch bands or to play or anything. Just hang out, do trivia, you know.
Yes.
Good times.
Yes. Well, thank you. Yeah. We have
this, thanks for that shameless plug again.
We have this door. I don't know if you can see it. See the door behind me?
Yeah, hold on. Let me widen that
up. There we go. Door into the beer cooler. And it's just kind of become a thing where people write on it. And then each year we erase the one, some have been there for like 4 years now, but, you know, people just say little things and cute little messages. And, you know, dad, he's made it. So he'll clean it off and he'll ask me which ones I want. And it's just pretty freaking awesome.
That's sweet.
That is cool. I love that.
Yeah. So
such style, such swag. Yeah.
That's
you just make it look so easy. It's so effortless, right? You just have all these things planned out and just run everything so smoothly.
I'm psycho. That's why. I make it look easy, but, you know, it's a lot. It was a lot of work. You know, I always say, you know, I don't work much in the winter at all. I kind of go nuts, but, you know, it's, you know, 16, 18 hour days, you know, 4 or 5 days a week. Come when we're in season. And, you know, my servers, they work a lot and they work hard, and, you know, they're outside for, you know, 12 hours a day, and it's a lot.
some of the best staff in the business, I got to say. I mean, I watch them work and they work hard.
I was so bummed because I've got a couple of my favorite, you know, they're not coming back this year because they're doing summer school. So it's rough. I'm like, I'm going to need four to replace those two. Yeah. So,
but Hannah, we love Hannah.
Hannah's not coming back.
No, I know. And that's, that she told me she's going to stay in school this year. And that's tough because she's just a highlight as well. And you've got, and we have to give Alex and Skylar a huge shout out because they are your backbone as well. And those girls, I've watched in the last few years doing the music trivia, I've watched Skylar grow so much.
She has.
And she runs a tight ship. I mean, she does. And I know Alex likes to be behind the scenes and doing her thing.
Yes.
But it's a great team you've built there. And to see these young girls who have grown up with you. I mean, didn't Skylar put your first dollar bill on the wall or something?
She did. Yeah, when we opened, she literally came running down the street, you know, to be our first sale, which was on Christmas in Springboro, 2009. So, yes, you know, Skylar grew up at my house. I mean, she was always, her and Alex have been friends forever. So, it's fun. It is a lot of fun. I get to spend each day with, you know, people that are amazing. So, they're my family.
Well, Heather's Coffee and Cafe, don't let the name steer you away. Yeah. Sometimes people see that name and they're like, you do trivia in a coffee shop? have you been to the patio?
Do you have a liquor license? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We'll even put liquor in your coffee if you want.
That's right. There's nothing wrong with that. No.
Heather, it's always great to see you and talk to you. And I look forward to another great season with you. And I know Jeff does as well playing there. I love seeing them play there too. So
thanks. I can't wait. And I'll start
looking forward to it.
What else you got, Jeffrey?
I think that's pretty much it. I mean, I think we pretty much hit everything and we've been going for a while now. But I just wanted to thank Heather again. And thanks again, Scott, for setting all this up. We appreciate it.
Apologize if anybody's still watching us, you know, apologize for the glitches that may happen. It is an internet issue today. The trouble is not your set. It's just us.
We are a little glitched.
And you know what? It's okay.
It's
all right. Heather, thank you so much, my dear.
Thanks, guys. Have a great day.
All right. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye. We'll see you, everybody.